Can we talk a little bit about the nervous system and how the nervous system creates that snap or that pop against the bag when you're creating that twist? How do we know that you're actually creating that whip, that quick reflex?
You need the recoil so that you can save the energy. You know, you don't want to punch yourself out. And since you're punching incorrect already, the muscle's already stressed. So the recoil is good because the whole body releases at the same time. Not one part of the body releases, the whole body. So if I snap through and my whole body comes back, every muscle went back to relaxing, ease at the same time, and not, I don't turn my foot. Now my back stretched, I'm overstretched, and I gotta come back. So I have to overstretch and have to pull back at the same time.
Coach, can you show us the wrong way to throw a jab or a hook,
right,
using the wrong mechanics of the net, of the leg? I want to show you guys how a boxer that's doing it wrong is not using the right mechanics in the leg to drive and then to create the neural power and explosivity and reflex of the upper body to make the bag pop.
Let's do it with the right hand, because a lot of fighters have a lot of faith in their right hand. So the wrong way is to turn, throwing power, but if you can look at my leg, my heel is still on the ground, my foot is flat, my knee is not turning. Therefore, I already feel the strain. One, I feel it in my groin, I feel it in my lower back, and it's already in my shoulder. I can already feel the strain. So that automatically is gonna have an injury. You're doing that at a high rate, so you don't feel it, but you're tearing something. Something's going wrong. Now, the best way is to throw it efficient so that the whole body releases and recoils same time. You know, like a rattlesnake. It curls, it releases, and comes back same time. Nothing, everything was smooth and flowing. So if I turn and I come back, I turn my whole body, snap, and snap back same way. Now when I don't turn my knee, don't turn my hip, I'm reaching, I have to overexpose.
And you're also off balance.
I'm off balance.
He's off balance, which basically exposes him to getting a hook in the face.
True.
or even another jab, whatever it may be.
If the
opponent moves out of the way and comes in from the other side, he's done. So it's really, really important that you understand that everything actually happens from the back leg.